I'd say that it's a big possibility that Kurt Busch would finally pull through and win for the first time this season. Plus, this is the same racetrack where racing fans saw Kurt win a NASCAR Cup race for the last time in this diecast universe, obviously, dating back to season 2 when he was still racing for Team Penske's number 22 ride at the time. Kurt is still in search for that first win at SHR, but maybe tonight that could happen. Tom, who do you got?
Chase Elliott, the son of awesome Bill from Dawsonville, is still looking for that first ever Cup Series dub. Sure, he's only won 3 times already this season in the Xfinity Series, but that's a lower series for those who are trying to earn their way up to the Cup Series, or back to the Cup Series for that matter. As we head to the final race of the regular season, Chase from the same place has finished inside the top 5 3 times and finished inside the top 10 6 times. One of those top 10 finishes came right here at Richmond International Raceway when season 4 was still at its beginnings. Kyle Busch led the most laps in the Toyota Owners 400 race here back when season 4, like you said, Tom, was still at its starting days. Speaking of that race, when the checkered flag flew, Kyle finished in 3rd place. Kyle Busch is locked into the chase either way with just one win, which was at the first Bristol race. The younger Busch starts this race from the 6th position, seeking that 2nd win of the season. Here we go again with technical difficulties reaching out to Tyler, but I suppose I'll say his prediction for the 1,000th time. But anyway, he's going for none other than the Southern 500 winner himself, NASCAR Fan 20. He and his team had started the season with ups and downs, but now as we head into the chase with this last race left in the regular season, he expects NASCAR Fan 20 to make something happen and put on a good show for the fans and score win number 4. To top it off, his first Cup win came right here at Richmond.
Turns out Tyler's not the only one having trouble with technical issues. Our old buddy Paul is also on the same page, as we could not hear a word he said. But good old Paul is going for Carl Edwards, who recently joined the Joe Gibbs Racing fleet. He has 3 wins under his belt as of right now, but let's see what happens when tonight's Richmond race comes to a satisfying conclusion. Will Cousin Carl pick up win number 4 later today? We'll find out sooner rather than later. This would also be a night to remember, since Edwards' car throws back to the day. Tony Stewart won his first checkered flag in his Cup Series career at this very track on September 11th, 1999, nearly 20 years ago. Not only did the throwback idea came from that, but since Tony Stewart is one of the inductees of the NASCAR Hall of Fame 2020 class, Coach Gibbs, Edwards, and even Stewart said, you know, why not? Will history repeat itself? We're about to find out. In reality, Denny Hamlin won the Richmond Full events in 2009, 2010, and 2016. With that being said, I'd say that in this diecast series, Hamlin will make it happen again. He's already showed what type of race racer he is when the chips are down, considering his aggressive driving here and there. Even if Mr. Hamlin either wrecks or finishes first, he's already secured a spot in the playoffs ever since his Charlotte 600 win.
It's been 5 long years for car number 5 for driver Casey Kane since he last tasted victory in this division. Literally, it's been since January 2014 that Casey won a race, which was the season finale race of season 1 at Miami. Yeah, it's been that long. All I can say is, now or never for Kane and the number 5 team if they want to advance into the chase for the Spring Cup. Despite the decent numbers of 3 top 5s and 6 top 10 finishes, a win will make a big difference in which will help put Casey up with the other 15 chase contenders, punching his ticket into the playoffs. The Trevor Bayne train is pulling out of the train station, folks, as he'll head to the finish line, hopefully out of the chase bubble. If Trevor finishes 10th or better, he'll knock Joey Logano right off the board, securing a spot in the chase, becoming the only Roush entry in the playoff grid.
Bad Brad will become the winner of tonight's Federated Auto Parts 400 race. I'm saying this because with the speed the number 2 team has right now, considering the fact Bradley finished inside the top 10 8 times, including an 8th in the previous race at Darlington, I'm pretty confident that Keselowski will get his first points paying win of the season tonight. Not only that, but he'll also gain quite a bit of momentum heading into the next race of the season, which would be the first race of the chase at the Chicagoland Speedway.
As we conclude the regular season, Dale Jr.'s current season did not disappoint in the slightest. I mean, really. With the chemistry this number 8 team put together back at the headquarters of HMS, Earnhardt managed to deliver 2 wins, 8 top 5s, and 14 top 10s. The highest ranking driver at the Engine Motorsports stable. This makes me and many others wonder, what if Dale Earnhardt Jr. wins tonight? What if he has a shot at a championship if he can advance into the final round? What if season 4 would be the season of Dale Earnhardt Jr.? Let's find out what will unfold and see who emerges victorious at the conclusion of the Federated Auto Parts 400 from the Richmond Raceway.